are we doing here? You never direct me where I want to go. You went right when I told you left. Or perhaps left when I said right. Which is it, you idiot? I've lashed myself to the mast of a sinking ship.
Friend or foe?
Friends, peace. I was told you might know where the Britons bring in their supplies.
Are we your friends, Dane?
I would have it so.
After years of blood and gore, looting and burning, forgive us if we don't trust a Dane.
Yes, I imagine you've known sword, fire, and death. That you have lost those close to you.
All of us have.
I have known that pain. It brought me to England to start anew. But Rodri and his Britons stand in my way, as they stand in yours.
I understand you well. Perhaps I spoke in haste. The Britons move their goods through Duston Quarry. See that tower to the south? That's the Hillgate remnants. Further on, you'll find the stone quarry.
The quarry is south of the tower. Thor must smile on me today. I have already destroyed the supplies there. Thank you for your time. There we are. The quarry and Wenlock are both done. That should shake Rodri to his senses. Now to Westbury, before Ivar causes more problems.
Won't be gentle if they spot me. Have a look soon.
Smell that, Jailbert?
I think so. A faint grassy odor?
There's Ivar. Jailbert, too.
There smells of distant.
Ivar, Jailbert.
Hey, Eivor. I was telling the Aetherlink here that Thor is with us this day. Our victory is assured.
So, what is your plan?
That bastard Anir commands this hamlet. So let us show these folks what happens when a village bows to the Britons. Smash it to kindling, burn it to ashes, and cut Anir's tender throat. Right, my boy?
I hope to fight well, not cruelly. The cutting of throats I leave to you.
Anir is the Britain's best warrior. If he dies a brutal death, Rhodri will think twice about fighting back.
Oh, my blood runs hot. Let us rush in now and leave a trail of bloody kindling.
A stealthy approach might earn us more time.
Bah! I prefer sound and fury. But do as you must.
Bloody kindling it is. We will smash this place to splinters.
Come, Jailbert! The fight is on!
Let the Saxon villages flee, Ivar. Only the Britons deserve our wrath.
Thor thunders beside us!
Yeah! Oh! Give me that gory! Master Z.
Get a good view of our handiwork, Talbert. Join us, Eivor! Look here! Look upon this masterpiece! Did you see Chilbert fight? He is all balls now.
I give thanks for victory and ask penance for taking lives.
Oh, Chilbert, your god bores me to death. Have a laugh. We won.
And I took no pleasure in it, Ivar.
Eivor and I were made for this, my boy. The song of swords, the blood mist, the bone crunch and baring of teeth.
To survive a battle is to be born anew in blood and streams.
My father died in a snake pit, left nothing but moldy bones and putrid flesh. But by the gods, he had earned a place at Odin's table.
Your father Ragnar left a strong saga. Talbert, I would know your mind on all this. Are you satisfied with our victory?
I believe I am. I'll need word from Rodri as soon as possible. What does he intend?
He will see the flames. He will know Westbury has been destroyed.
The bleeding puspit claims only a dragon can defeat him. He will soon put that to the test.
It is peace we want, Ivar, not revenge. If you cannot accept that, return to Repton now.
You do not know Rodri as I do, Eivor. You do not know what a slippery, lying shit he can be.
Enough talk of killing. I need a moment of calm.
You need mead.
No, Ivar. True calm. A walk in the woods to clear the air. Or fishing. Would you go fishing with me?
Fishing, huh? Looking for a warm puddle to dangle your worm in?
I saw a small pond nearby. Will you come?
We can all take a moment to allow our blood to cool.
It's just up here.
I have no fondness for fishing. Where is the sport in it? There's no chance the fish will kill me.
Here will be good. Let's fish for eel. Dale have relishes nettle soup cooked with eels fresh from the water.
I will not fish. You go ahead.
Water's boiling with them.
Thank you.
sure? Well done, Abel. An eel. Bring it to shore. Another eel. Almost enough for a hearty soup. Sailor will be pleased. Let's go tell Ivar about our catch.
It took longer than clearing this village.
We caught some eel for a feast. The bishop should be pleased.
The simple fellow comes now.
Ah, a strange way to celebrate victory. But then again, our Christ was a fisher of souls, was he not?
Bishop, greetings. We've the makings for a delicious soup.
I'm grateful, Chaelbert, but my heart is heavy. So many homes burnt. We'll be years rebuilding.
You should have seen Chaelbert fight. He will be an elderman with sack and guts, fearsome and raw.
I should rather be fair and just, but I take the compliment.
I have sent word to the Britons. I pray King Rodri will again be open to peace, in spite of his brother's murder.
It worked in our favor. Look where we landed. Britons begging for mercy like whiny pups.
We set the village ablaze, yes. But peace is not guaranteed. And it will take another sort of skill to win it. Restraint.
Our next steps are critical, my lords. And after what happened in Quatford, it is clear to me that Ivar should lay low.
Lay low? After all I have done here, you tell me to dunk my head?
The good bishop is right, Ivar. You have a warrior's heart, not a peacemaker's.
Fuck you, wolf-kissed. I know Rodri, and I know the kind of tricks he will pull. That is me warning you. If you hear me farting, that is my welcome to the bastard.
You bruised his pride, Eivor.
If you have some balm for it, by all means, share it.
His pride makes him difficult, and his anger makes him hasty. But he is not without honest feeling. I will hunt him a great boar, I think. And together we'll roast it over a fire and tell tales of war. That should please him.
Bishop, we must prepare for Rodri's arrival. Rally our men and set up a camp just here.
Peace or war will be decided, but not yet, not now. We must wait.
I loathe waiting.
It is all in God's hands. We can but pray and give thanks for this moment of rest.
The Britons have come!
The moment has ended.
This way, by the great oak!
Where is Chaelbert? He ought to be present for these talks as our future elderman.
He went hunting. For wild boar, he said.
That was quite some time ago, no?
We cannot wait. We should settle the peace now.
Lady Angharad, greetings.
We come to speak of peace.
We are gladdened to hear it. But where is your great king?
He stays at the castle at my behest. I feared his presence would inflame the cutthroat Ivar.
We have confined our cutthroat to his tent.
Both of us fretting over our war-hungry companions. It seems we are of the same mind.
A surplus of caution never did any harm. I count this as a blessing.
Perhaps then, at long last, we can end this war. Our peoples have suffered enough.
And your proposal?
We shall withdraw all our soldiers to the time-honored border of our lands. We ask only that you give us some days to collect our furnishings and leave Kausto Castle. In return, you pledge to end all hostilities as of this moment.
These terms are generous. We have a truce.
Truly.
Praise be, this is well and quickly done. God go with you and your king, Lady Angharad.
I salute you all. You waged a good war. Let us now wage a lasting peace.
I stand bewildered, Eivor. In the blink of an eye, years of blood and sweat are put to an end.
You have walked a difficult road, Bishop.
Chaelbert must learn the good news. Will you tell him when you see him?
I'll find him now. I need your eyes. Have you seen Chaelbert?
I don't keep track of the comings and goings of the Alderling. Ask another.
I am looking for Chaelbert. Have you seen him?
Last I saw, he was sharpening arrowheads.
Ivar, it is done.
Peace, eh? And now everyone is shitting themselves with happiness.
If not happiness, then relief. Have you seen Chaelbert? I want to pass on the good news.
He asked me to go hunting earlier, but I am in no such mood.
Hey, Eivor.
Have you seen Chaelbert?
My brother saw him last.
Drunk as a mackerel, isn't he?
Celebrating the peace. Got started early.
Wake up!
Huh?
Where is Chaelbert?
Chaelbert?
Did none of you see Chaelbert?
Only him, Drenger. You will have to wait until he sleeps it off.
Does he often get this soaked?
By all the gods, he does. Twice a week. Once for 3 days, another for 4. Then twice on Sundays.
And when you need him to sober up, what do?
Keep this to yourself, but once or twice when I needed a quick word, I dumped him in a lake.
It's worth a try.
Must be some way I can wake this drunk.
What? Am I on fire? I've burned my branch and berries off.
I am looking for Tailbert.
So you set me afire, Wrath of Surtr?
If you must know, the little brat went off hunting boar some time ago.
Yes, I know. But where was he hunting?
He went south. That's all I know. Probably followed the stream here, south to the forest.
That's enough to go on. Thank you. See you, old friend.
What happened here? This doesn't look good. Thank you. heard.
Gilbert. Tears of Freya. Gilbert, you live. Stay quiet. You're badly hurt. A dragon on the hilt. Guards. The Briton dressed. Keep breathing, boy. You haven't got long. I will take you back to say your goodbyes. I can get you to the others. I'll go easy. Save your strength.
Some help here! Ivar! Leonav!
By the hand of Thor!
Is that the other?
Eivor! What happened? No! No! You foolish boy, what did you do?
I found him deep in a cave, beset by wolves.
Ivar.
Easy, boy. Easy.
Ivar.
Get me an axe, right fucking now!
Ivar. He's gone.
An axe!
His god will take him as he is, axe or not.
Go, dear god, boy. And I will sing for you in Valhalla. This was no wolf. Tell me what happened.
The Britons did this. I found this blade in his chest.
A Briton's dagger. Rodri! But why?
You murdered his brother. Did you think he would let that lie so easily?
I told you he was a trickster. Peace was never his goal. He takes blood for blood.
Bishop Deolav, over here.
The walls of his fortress will not protect him. I will sheath this dagger into his lungs.
We must move fast, then. Attack before Rodri can revel in his trick.
No mercy this time, Wolfkist. You spared that wet-turd Leofrin. We will not spare Rodri.
I swear.
Lord above, what's happened? Chaelbert!
Murdered.
May the Lord who frees you from sin save you and raise you up.
Send the boy's body to his father, who won the Christian burial. Lady Angharad said Rotary is holed up in Kausto Castle. That may have been a lie or a tiny slip. Either way, we should find out.
There is a spot near the fortress to set up camp. We will scout it together.
A good plan. We go now.
Fine. And remember, leave Rotary to me.
What has happened?
The only way to find out what to do is to ask the Volvo. Or the elves. They both are part of the city.
Mount up and follow me. There's work to be done. I should have seen this coming. I should have known he would come for the weakest of us.
You opened a bloody wound when you killed Rodri's brother.
Anything worth doing must be paid for in blood.
Quartford, you told me Rodri gave you that scar on your face. Is it a story worth telling?
It's not worth telling, it is worth remembering. Years ago, I was headed back from the Western Isle. Taken a bit of a beating, put me in a surly mood. I wanted blood and silver, nothing more. So, me and my Drangir sailing along the coast of Camry, see a nice spot for landing, covered in mist. We drag our ships ashore. And just then, a cry came from atop a hillock. The troll cursed Britons. The fog clears a bit. And there they are, all lined up. The biggest one calls out, "I am Rodri, king of this land. That means shit to me." I scream back. I give my boys a nod. And we raise up our axes and charge before they take a breath. We have the numbers. But the Britons are clever. It's marshland. The bog catches our boots, sucks us to a standstill. One by one, Rodri cuts us to bits. He gets to me, lays his blade at my cheek, and gives me this nick. "Leave this land and give your people fair warning," he says. "Tell them King Rodri gave you that cut." "Hand shit," I say. Rodri laughs and lets me go.
Quite a story, Ivar. Son of Ragnar, killer of kings, conqueror of England and the Western Isle. You have lived the saga worth 10.
That I have. That sweat-sopped slug is just beyond those walls. May only be defeated by a dragon, my itching ass. He'll meet one, all right.
Send a message to your men. We can build a camp here and lay plans for a surprise attack.
Ivar's men waste no time. They're eager to pay out our revenge.
I've been waiting to get back at these Britons ever since you broke me from that cage, Dane. The time is nigh. There's my liberator. I'll do you proud, I will.
Eivor, I'm ready to get back at them Britons. You'll not see me lagging behind doing nothing but looting corpses. Not this time.
I am ready.
What in the name of Loki have you done?
Called in the dragon to help me slay Rodri. Now what say you, Wolfkist? Are you ready for war?
Rally the men, Ivar. Let's have at it.
It is a good day to die.
The gate looks to be well defended.
My men are loading a cart with cauldrons of oil. We will blast right through that fucking gate. Show yourself!
I am here, boneless Ragnarsson. How is it you come in force when our peace has been concluded?
Do not mock us, whore son. You splattered blood on our peace with the butchery of young Gelbert.
Speak what nonsense you please, Dane. If you mean war, our defenses are sure.
Gaze upon my face, King of Crowfood, and meet the dragon that will devour you.
I see a spent old man playing at serpents.
Enough talking, Ivar.
Bring the oil cart and set the fires. When I am done with Rodri, I will tear the fat from his shanks and use it to fry our bread. Get the cart, boys!
Get up!
In front of the gate!
Get the wagon to the gate!
Please.
Get back! I'll light it up!
Watch out!
Ivar the Boneless. You make a pitiful dragon.
I need some fresh air. I failed the rotting old oak.
He's not dead.
No. I have something else planned. Spectacle, remember?
The man is dying. Come away. Let the Nornir spin his fate.
Oh, no. This will be good. I have something specific in mind. A place, and a method. Come!
All right. Let's get this over with.
Load this lump of lard onto your horse, and we will go. Take care he stays alive.
Abel! Do not forget that load of rotten flesh called Brodri.
Where are we going?
An overlook I found while scouting. A view, one fit for a dying king.
There's no need for spectacle, Ivar. Let the man die with honor.
No, no, no. He must die with style. Dear King, stay with us. You must not miss what is coming. I killed King Ella, King Osbard, King Edmund, and now King Roderick. Who else can claim such a string of victories?
It is not my place to interfere in this feud.
Ah,
Valhalla must look such a sight. Does he breathe still?
Barely.
Rodri, are you listening? For years I wore this scar with shame. Nicked by a Briton and left alive. I tried to cover it with a beard, a cloak. But as your fame grew, I began to beam with pride. A king gave me this mark. What say you to this, Rodri? Huh? Speak up, you old bag of sweat and grease. Here we are. Bring him close. Where in the name of Loki have you gone to? Ah.
Up there to the top and keep him breathing.
Finish this quickly, Ivar.
See here? A hungry blade. Now comes the dragon to feed on his favorite meal. The blood eagle.
Ivar, is this...
The birth of a blood eagle is a sight to behold, my friend. First, I slice the length of your spine.
That is a Norseman. The true essence of old heroes. The Blood Eagle has no true meaning for Ivar. He is doing it simply to take pleasure in suffering.
Now, I pull back the flesh.
The method will always outlive the meaning. Few in time will care why this man died. But the how, that is a song for the ages. The fog between good and evil grows thick over time, but glory never fades. There is nothing glorious here. Life is not pretty. It is a bloody fight.
Out comes lungs, and we spread them like wings. All of Mercia can see him now.
I have seen enough.
We are not finished, Eivor. This saga we have written together, it needs an ending. Here and now.
It is ended, Ivar. I'm done with this place.
A fight to the death. You and me. If I win, I am the greatest Vikinger who ever lived. If I lose... What a tale you have to tell.
You are battle drunk, Ivar. Goodbye.
Poor Chaelbert. He barely said a word.
When?
I pushed that dragon dagger into his heart.
No.
Just a soft little squeal. Then, nothing.
You sick, cursed fuckhound!
The things a man must do. Trials one must face, the friends one must betray, to achieve one's destiny, and become King Killer forevermore.
Traitor! Chaelbert was
like a son to me! Yes! Yes! So fight me, Wolfkiss, to a glorious death! is the life, Eivor! To fight high above the world! Valhalla, awake! You know me, Eivor! You even backed me when I killed Roderick's half-wit brother! Bleed! Like jailbirds! Ask you something.
Speak then. Why take your tongue?
Will you see your father in Valhalla, Wolfkist? Or is the coward in Helheim weeping tears of ice? Gold again! Watch out! Valkyrie's approach. My axe, Eivor. Hand me my weapon.
Odin may have use for you, but this is more than you deserve. Do not shame him.
I hear their wings.
Carry the body to Quatford. We will say our goodbyes there. And send a message to Ubba. Tell him his brother is dead.
Niederstufen at an Elsevere.
Eivor, hello. Another dark day clouds our victory.
Bishop. Over.
Dead at the hands of a Briton. I cannot imagine the shame my brother felt in his final hour. Were it not for this peace...
I killed him.
You?
After peace was made, Ivar murdered Gelbert and pinned the crime on Rodri to get another swing at him.
How do you come to know this?
He told me himself.
I am always one who desires the truth, Eivor. But this... this is a hard thing to hear. Did he die well?
He died a fighter, in all his glory.
As he wanted, then. With Ivar gone, peace and quiet are now possible. That is something. I will console myself for the thought that we will meet again in Valhalla. Axe in hand.
You will.
For good or ill, he lived life by his own rules. What man can say better?
He lived his life at cross purposes. I often found him strange and his actions puzzling. But not all men are meant to be understood.
He needs a proper farewell. I will prepare a ship for his funeral pyre.
Bishop, send word to Lady Angharad. Say that her husband died by treachery, and that Ivar has paid the price for it.
As soon as I am able.
Have you heard from King Ceolwulf? I cannot imagine his grief.
He is felled by it. Still, he makes plans for this shire. I am to be elderman here. Therefore, Shiropshire declares herself your friend and ally, and will remain so for the length of my days.
I'm grateful, Bishop.
God go with you, Eivor, wherever you may lead.
One sails into a singing glory on a flaming water steed.
Wind across the water. The battle maidens beat their wings to carry a king to Odin's hall of corpses.
Ivar gone. Shiropshire an ally. I should confer with Randvi.
mine them. Keep this. It serves your cause better than it does my pocket.
Ah, good. I hope this one did not give you too much trouble.
As a token of my deep gratitude, I want you to have this.
There are more medallions to collect.
I have to go.
Then go in peace.
I would like to reorganize the crew.
Good for now?
I will see you later. Show me.
Celestine!
Your baker is done, Tarvin. And our feasting table will be warmer for it.
Eivor, that is kind of you. I hope one day I can repay you.
You are among friends here. There's no need.
No need, but a desire. An earnest one. I remember the good things people do for me. To warm my heart in times when kindnesses are few and far between. There was one more thing, though, if you had a moment. A grain merchant has set up downriver. I want to bring a half dozen bags home, but I would need an extra pair of hands.
I can lend a hand.
That's a relief. I did not fancy asking Holger.
Tarbin, what brought you to our clan?
Your reputation. Heard folk say a band of hard-drinking, battle-scarred warriors had washed up on shore. Said you had settled in the center of Mercia, taking in whatever flotsam, jetsam, and jumble of misfits came to your docks.
And this appealed to you?
More than anything. Always been a bit of a drifter. The thought of settling in a rowdy camp felt like a good balance. And being a baker, I knew my services would not be sniffed at.
I did not take you for a baker when we met. You have the look of someone who swings an axe.
I do hear that a lot.
But baking is your only craft, is that right?
I have always enjoyed it. And I have always been good at it. But when I'm not able to find such work, I take odd jobs where I can. So long as I can work with my hands.
Well, we have that in common.
A question, Eivor. You're a warrior, a fighter. That much I know. But if you could stop fighting, what would you do?
You ask the wrong question. I can stop fighting, but to do so would be to deny the essence of who I am. I think you mean, if I had to stop fighting, what would I become?
No, you've given me the answer I wanted. It's good you found what calls you. A rare and happy thing.
Yes, yes, I see you both. What can I... It's you. What are you doing in Mercia?
Collecting grain. 30 silvers worth, if you can spare it. I do have the coin.
Right. Well... Take what you need and get going.
That should cover it. Thank you kindly.
Of course. And you, you take good care of yourself. Yeah?
Is that your usual vendor? He seemed a little surprised to see you.
Did he? Well, could be he knows somebody who looks like me. There's no shortage of big bearded men around here, yeah?
I suppose not. About your question earlier, what would I do if I weren't a warrior? I would ask the same of you. Is baking bread your greatest wish?
Is there something wrong with wanting to bake bread? The Romans baked bread. The Egyptians baked bread.
It is a fine trade. But is it your calling?
It is my calling to feed people, I'd say. To be of service to those I care for. And who care for me. That brings me joy.
But that way, it is a noble pursuit.
I don't know that it's noble. It is simply what gets me up in the morning. It gives me purpose for the rest of my day.
Need help with your grain?
No need. I'll do the rest myself. Bring it in and put it where I like.
All right. It was good to speak with you, Tobin. A welcome diversion.
You too, Eivor. Thank you for your help.
Come! A little dice never caused any harm.
Cast about this lad, my friend. Do you see? Show me what lies ahead.
man be? One of us?
We are allied with Shropshire, but at a grievous cost. Young Chelbet was killed.
Yes, my scouts told me. Such a tragic death for so dubious a gain. I hope you paid his killers back in kind.
Justice was done.
Chelbet will be remembered. He was good company in the short time he was with us.
He was.
Have you spoke with Hydam about Vinland?
I have.
Good. I have marked it on the map with a bit of guesswork as to its location. Let me know when you wish to leave.
Should we take this to your chamber?
No need.
Eivor? A moment.
Tekla, you look like you wrestled a bear. Is something wrong?
Gods, Eivor! I was robbed! On the road between here and Lincoln!
By who? Did you get a good look at them?
They were Saxons, I know that much. A pack of them lifted 4 barrels of my ale and all the coin I had on me. The biggest one pulled me off my horse and stuck his mouth in my ear, said, "Tell Guthban we expected him home soon."
Guthban? That's battlebone in the Saxon tongue. Are you sure?
That's what he said. It's not someone here, is it?
Not that I know of.
I do not begrudge us taking in orphans, Eivor, but some of these Saxons, we hardly know them. You ought to ask around.
A good idea. You take care of yourself. Let me see to this.
Thank you, Eivor.
Tarbin, do you have a second? I was wondering if...
I am Guthban, Eivor. It means battlebone. Not the name of a cheery baker, is it?
Not one who bakes bread, no. So, how did you earn this name?
Before I came here, I lived another life. A brutal, bloody life. I served with a gang of mercenaries. I was their weapon, roaming the wilds of England. Did whatever they asked of me, and all they asked was violence. When I left, I laid this sword on the grass and made a vow. I swore never to spill another drop of blood, to abandon acts of violence, to never kill again.
A hard promise for a hard man.
It wasn't, not for me. This life here is all I've ever wanted. I've never been more at peace. This is my doing. I brought all this upon you. It is down to me to fix it.
Tarbin, by threatening you, they threaten my clan. I cannot allow that.
These men are foul, Eivor. You should not have to fight my battles for me.
Do you not hear me, Tarbin? If they threaten you, they threaten me. So let us face them. Together.
Very well. Meet me outside when you're ready. I believe I know where they will be.
If you wish to face your old friends, I'm ready when you are.
Good. I'll lead the way. I want you to know, should it come to blows with my old crew, I can handle it myself. Forgiving me is all the work you need to do.
There's nothing to forgive. You walked away. They pursued. My axe or by fist, I will do what must be done to protect my clan.
You're living the life you want, aren't you?
Before we are spotted, tell me what I should expect here. Will they attack us on sight?
I shouldn't think so. No. Nothing like that. It's not how Wilf operates. Yes, he's a clever one. He's rather kind when you meet him. Makes you feel like you're a friend. Family. I met him a decade ago, and he was the first person to truly welcome. To see some value in you. He told me I had a gift. For intimidation. Persuasion. Violence. Just by the size and strength of me, he knew how to use me.
What do they want from you now?
They'll want me back.
No!
They'll want me to be the man they think I am. Monstrous and massive. Wilf and them were the only family I had then. But their love was conditional. Wilf only loves what he owes.
So what do you intend?
I know I won't go back. I don't want more blood on my hands. But apart from that, it's hard to say. Who knows what they have in mind?
We're stopping.
That house, there. They're likely within. It won't look like much, Eivor. But don't be fooled. And don't take Wilf lightly, charming as he seems. The man is a serpent.
I've met plenty of charmers who turned out to be snakes.
I know. Only a warning. Let's go inside.
My boy, as I live and breathe, you got my message, and you brought a friend. Who might you be, Dane? His new leash?
I am Eivor, and the woman you robbed was one of my clan. That will not stand.
I know. I'm busted up about it. But tell Tekla, was it? Tell her that her ale is some of the finest we've tasted.
I am done with you, Wilf.
But we are not done with you, boy. We gave you food, shelter, ale to drink, riches galore. We made you who you are.
For all you did for him, he repaid you with blood and sweat, did he not?
You're a fiery one, I like that. But the ink was dried on this deal well before your number arrived in England. If you wish to clear Tarbin's name, I'm happy to help with that. It's only a small matter of cost. Some weeks back, soldiers confiscated my personal wares, shall we say. Tried to confiscate me as well, but I gave them the slip. If you're keen, you could recover my belongings and return them to me. Do that, and your name is clear.
I can't. I promised myself I would leave all this behind. But
if it will clear Tarbin's name, we will recover what is yours. Where are these soldiers?
Camped not far to the west. A battalion of bloated, brainwashed military men. You can't miss it for the smell.
Wait here, then. We will return before you sprout another pair of horns.
God go with you, Eivor.
You found it!
I did. Let's bring this back to Wilf.
You handled that better than I would.
Oh, they have returned!
We have your goods.
Beautiful. Beautiful, put them there.
The ledger.
Of course. Happy to honor it. My goodness, such a lack of trust these days. It's a dark age, no mistake.
That's it, then. We're done?
Aye. You are free to walk from this place and live as Tarbin the Boring Breadmaker for the rest of your days. But you, Eivor, if you ever get tired of the settled life, we could always use a thief with your skills. Think about it.
Tarbin, are you satisfied?
Yes. I cannot thank you enough, Eivor. I feared the worst when I heard my old moniker, Guthrum. Hadn't heard it in years. Yes. I cannot thank you enough, Eivor. I feared the worst when I heard my old moniker, Guthrum. Hadn't heard it in years. Dredges up fearful memories.
I imagine. How did you fall in with that bunch?
After my mother died, I sought family. Wilf offered it. He looked at me, took me in and told me who I was. Who I could be. I don't crave that belonging anymore. Among you lot, people accept me as I am. The greatest gift I ever got. Peace.
Many men are calm because they've never known a storm. You weathered the storm and worked through it. That is a rare thing.
That means a lot. Thank you. It's good to be home again. That is, if I haven't robbed myself of the pleasure of calling it home.
Tarbin, in spite of all, you're welcome here. And you owe us nothing but the work you love.
Right. Payment in fresh loaves of bread. I can manage that.
But first, one scrap of your past remains.
Right. The ledger.
Toss it. And purge the past.
With pleasure.
I want to see the Alliance map. What can you tell me of Vinland? Is it a real place or merely a rumor?
Rumor or not, I found someone willing to sail you there. She claims to have seen it once before.
If she is willing to risk her life beside me and make the long journey, I will take her at her word.
Nessa is her name. Meet her at the docks when you are ready to leave.
I will go now, and end the life of Gorm Kjotvason where the Valkyries cannot find him.
It is a long voyage, Eivor. Be careful.
Come to me.
Good day.
Yes.
Good day to you, stranger.
Nessa, is it? I'm Eivor. Randvi said you would be my guide.
That is right. Passage to across the seas to St. Brenton's land. Is that right?
Randvi called it Vinland.
One and the same. It is a 3-week trip by longship. Arduous, dull, possibly fatal.
Should we survive, you will be compensated.
Eivor, before you go, you must be dressed as a thrall when you arrive. To be seen as you are would raise suspicions. Gorm runs this new camp, and it is a good bet all but a few will be loyal to him.
Good thinking.
Only taking care of our prized Drenger.
First things first, Eivor. My ship, my rules. Second, you follow the rules. Third, if you listen to my rules, you live.
Understood.
Good. Let me know when you're ready and we'll get going. ready to set sail?
I will leave my gear behind and dress the part. To Vinland we go.
Hop in. We'll leave now.
Three cold weeks on the Whale Road. Past mountains of ice and kingdoms of stone. Saga lands. All this way to kill a man. Gorm Kjotvison, the son of my father's old foe. What dark work does the Order have so far across the open sea? Someone in charge. I'd better step with care. No friends here.
You! You look stronger than most of the others. What's your name?
Jora of Jorvik.
Jora? As in horse?
My father never wanted children. What is this place?
Newhaven. A wild place found on no map.
Are we settling here?
That is not our plan. Too many wild folk in the woods.
They threaten us?
You ask too many questions, horse. Your task is to keep your mouth shut and do as I tell you. Now, unload that ship and then I'll have you carry those carrots.
Hildi!
Hildi! Hildi! We can't find Olaf.
Loki's ours, not again.
We cannot send supplies to Gorm without his guidance.
Ugh! Pull what supplies we have to the nearest camps, then. Gorm's men will do the rest.
Let me go. I can carry whatever supplies Gorm needs.
That's Olaf's job, horse, not yours. You stick to this port and keep your head down. Ask around about Olaf. Someone must know where he has run off to.
If I can find...
til dag í hak.
Hvað ber til?
Thank you.